Hey guys, so recently I replayed through Bioshock. So this was just my second playthrough, and I did it about a month and a half ago. And it was just like this idea of playing Bioshock in 2013, because the last time I played it before that was when it originally came out on 2007. I played on my friend's Xbox 360, and returning to it. It was really interesting experience and experiment to me. Usually when I revisit a game that I haven't played in such a long, long time, what ends up happening is that I realize that I had these really thick nostalgia goggles on. And, you know, going back to it, I realize I don't have them on anymore, and it's just like, wow, this game has not aged well at all. This game is actually, like, I don't remember how I enjoyed this game so much as a kid. Like, how was this fun to me? That kind of feeling. Bioshock ends up being the totally opposite thing. Because when I first played through Bioshock, I was really harsh with it. A lot of that opinion still holds for me. I was not as big a fan. One thing I really did enjoy about Bioshock was its atmosphere, its graphics, the water effects were just so amazing to me in those days. I was so floored by it. The concept of this underwater city, rapture that pulls you in, that you enter, and that you explore around, and you see it crumbling away, and there are all these lunatics that just pop out of nowhere and just start attacking you, and it's an incredible experience that way. Has an incredible story. After playing that, I had to conclude, like, this is the best story in first-person shooter genre. That was the conclusion I had. I know many of you guys who played many more games than me probably will disagree, but that was the conclusion I had. It's a conclusion I still hold to for the most part, excluding Bioshock Infinite, because I think that trumps it. But yeah, that was kind of the positive, how I viewed the game, but I also did not like playing the game. I thought there was a lot of design choices in the game that made the gameplay really annoying and frustrating. I did not, for example, like having to do hacking minigames so damn much. That was an issue for me. And the fact that, like, I don't know, like, the gunplay, there were a lot of things that I just didn't like about the gameplay of Bioshock 1. A lot of that still ended up being true, actually. So I'm still a harsh critic now as I was then, which is interesting. But what ended up happening as I was playing through this game in 2013 is I ended up having such more reverence towards it. Because it reminds me of what first-person shooter genres have kind of turned into now. What most first-person shooter games are no longer like Bioshock. Because I feel like Bioshock, the way it was made, that was like a norm in that era of how first-person shooter games are. Or if it's not the norm, then it was kind of a norm a little before, where, you know, you're in one setting, and you explore this one area, so that's a concept, and you have multiple weapons that you carry with you at all times, and not just two weapons at a time, which is a Halo, Call of Duty. Every single first-person shooter game seems to do that now, except for very notable few. So that's an issue. And incorporating like rather complex RPG mechanics into the shooting, into the overall gameplay experience. In certain ways, Bioshock, in a way, kind of feels like Deus Ex. In a way, not as complex, but they're still there, you know? That kind of upgrade chain is kind of rare to see, or it's not rare to see, it's just different. First-person shooter games with RPG mechanics are just, it has just a lot more mainstream feel to it, or the mechanics are much more streamlined so that it's not like that anymore. It's an era of first-person shooter games. And Bioshock is like, it feels like the end of it, you know? And that way, I really respect it so much. I also respect, you know, a lot of the design choices that really push the narrative forward first-person shooter games don't do that. Unless they're made by Irrational Games, it seems like. You know, Bioshock Infinite does that, where the whole point of the experience is to push this narrative forward. And it's quite amazing, really, because the narrative is so strong and so compelling and so well-written. So that's really, it works. You know, if that wasn't the case, if the writing was bad, if the narrative wasn't compelling, if the setting wasn't compelling, if the characters were just bland or stereotypical, this kind of method of storytelling in a first-person shooting game would not have worked. But it works really well, and I gotta give it props for that. And I gotta give it props for the audio log thing, you know? The ability to pick up an audio log and listen to it, listen to dialogue that is more backstory about the game as you're playing through the game, as you're shooting things up, as you're in combat, exploring the world of Rapture, or the world of Columbia in Bioshock Infinite. It's awesome. It's still not used in so many other first-person shooter games, but it should. It's so much better than the concept of putting an in-game radio on this in-game table and having the player stand right in front of it and just stand there and pause just to listen to the whole audio thing. That's just... It's realistic, sure, but it's a very boring concept to just stand there to listen to it. You know, most players are just going to walk right past that. And that's a lot of voice work that just has gone to waste. So that's my 2 cents on that. But yeah, I came to appreciate a lot more. Playing in 2013, I didn't mind the hacking games as much, which was surprising. I just found it really, it's a difficult game. One of the worst aspects of Bioshock is that it is designed around the fact that you can use a bio chamber to spawn back to life every time you die without any consequences. And the game seems to know that because ammo is really scarce. Enemies are, they just pop out of nowhere and they do so much damage to you. It's a pretty difficult game. And also, ammo is super expensive. So, eventually, you know, I came to kind of just exploit this kind of buy the chamber thing. By getting enough money, I didn't spend any on ammo. I would just find ammo by exploring, which is great. What I would do is I would use money for plasmids. I don't even buy health. For Eve. For the Eve thingy, that to put more... to fill up your Eve meter. That's all I would buy. Just so that when I encounter enemies... I used to, you know, regular traditional combo of Shock, Ranch, Shock, Ranch, Shock, Ranch. Like, that's the best combo to use, and it's the most effective one. That's, the problem with that also is the fact that in Bioshock, a lot of the other plasmids are kind of useless. The fire one's awesome, but it doesn't do as much gradual damage as quickly as it can. It lights them on fire, they freak out. But they can still live for so long even though they're on fire. B1, very minimal damage. The ice one, great concept, but I don't use it because once you use it and you shatter them into pieces, you don't get to loot any item. They don't drop any items once you freeze them and shatter them. So that's a total waste. There's so many items, there are so many plasmids that are just kind of worthless. The best ones for me were fire, shock, and telekinesis, because you can throw grenades back at people. But really, like, the other ones, like, controlling a Big Daddy was useful in certain situations, but it takes a lot of Eve. I don't know. It's an interesting game with a lot of options. I have great reverence for this game, much more respect for this game than I've ever had before, playing in 2013. It has aged really well. The water effects still look pretty damn good. Graphics in this game, pretty still damn good. It's a very unique game. There's no other game like it except Bioshock 2. So that's saying something. And Bioshock 2, I feel like, plays better. A lot of the complaints I had about Bioshock 1's gameplay is addressed in Bioshock 2. Of course, Bioshock 1 has a better, compelling narrative. It is designed directly by Irrational Games, where Bioshock 2 isn't. So it's more tightly cohesive game experience, but Bioshock 2 seems to play better, and it's more fun to play. Yeah, so those are my kind of general thoughts about playing this game in 2013. It was quite an experience. It's interesting that I come to love this game so much later on my second playthrough, after, 7 years or so. So, those are my thoughts. Cheers.